Stadium in Tampa, Florida. Just a short time ago, the Buccaneers emerging from their tunnel to the roar of this frenzied crowd here in the Sunshine State. And we're in the big ship, and fittingly, everyone here ready to do battle as Tampa Bay gets ready to match up with the Denver Broncos. That'll be taken in the end zone. And all that work, but he stopped where he ultimately would have been, and he simply taken a knee, and that's the 25-yard line. Go with a ground attack here, and it'll work his way across the 30 to the 32. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a 2nd and 3.
That run right there was an offensive line coach's dream, wasn't it? Guys picked up all of their assignments, created a nice gap for the running back to get through, pick up 7 yards. Yeah, he's probably chortling on the headset right now saying, "We got it going, boys. Let's keep it going."
Give him 3 yards and a fresh set of downs.
So many teams want to throw the ball in this situation nowadays, but I love watching a team that has enough confidence to go ahead and run the football in that situation. That's almost a tendency breaker.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play there. 2nd down. Big boys down there in the trenches, and a nice play to stop them. Pulled nothing there.
Yeah, when you talk about big boys, you talk about those defensive tackles, those nose tackles. They're not just big, they're immense. And what a big-time play there.
Stop made there by Gerald McCoy. On 3rd down, that's Lindsey. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. That one good for 13 and a Denver 1st down. Defense had a chance to get off the field here on the opening drive, couldn't do it.
I know that we go into these meetings with coaches, and sometimes maybe we can get, you know, a little bit numb because they're always going to talk about how important 3rd down is, aren't they? Offense and defense. In this case, one capitalized, and the other, as you said, had a chance to get off the field and didn't get it done.
Now Keenum finds Jake Butt over the middle, and he'll be brought down, it looks like, right at the 40. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
Able to get 7 on that 1st down pass play. 2nd and 3. And they'll go on the ground. And he's going to get this inside the 30. Give him 14 yards there and a Denver 1st down.
And that's a run that'll energize an offensive line. They'll take that one all day long. Fundamental breakdown by the defense. You've got to be able to make plays on the edge. Let's go, let's go.
First carry for Royce Freeman. Down right around the 25. Credit him with a 1-yard gain there to make it 2nd and 9.
Nice job by the defensive front there to hold him to a short gain on 1st down. Well played, I must say.
Rush coming, and he's taken down. Carl Nassib in there to sack him for a loss of 6.
Enough takes a start to have a good drive. Quite like a big loss on a sack, does it?
Now they're looking at a 3rd and long, and suddenly the momentum shifted to the other side of the football.
And old Mike is a very, very fickle man.
Throwing is Keenum, flush to his right. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Chris Conte, and his guys will take over. At the 30-yard line. Winston and the Bucs take over now, 1st and 10, right at the 30.
5 on the 50. 5 on the 50. 5 on the 50. Even.
And they'll run it here. They'll take this up just shy of the 40. Excellent display of footwork on that run. A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two. On second down. Room to run past midfield. It's caught by Mike Evans. And finally marked down at the 42-yard line. A good pick up there of 20 yards. And that's the first connection. The number one overall pick at 2015 finding the number seven pick at 2014 in Evans.
And what a great target Mike Evans is for Jameis Winston. Winston's a pretty accurate thrower, but that catch radius that Evans provides, that makes him that much more dangerous.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. Jameis now on first down. He couldn't quite hold it. Got hit. Ball pops out. Incomplete. Seems like this defense, especially the secondary, has really been contesting about every throw in this first half.
Remind me of a good half-court defensive basketball team. Every time a pass is thrown, they're right there in good defensive position, able to affect the play.
Ball on the 42 as they come up second and 10. A second down throw for Winston. He's got the hookup here to DeSean Jackson. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. So they'll take the yardage and tack on 15 more for the face mask.
Talk about a play that absolutely costs you in the end. Just trying to do your job, right? Trying to get him on the ground. Next thing you know, they march up another 15 against your squad.
Winston out of throw on first down. And he's into the end zone for a Tampa Bay touchdown. O.J. Howard, a 16-yard touchdown. And the Bucs are able to strike for six.
The big fellow was the recipient there for that touchdown pass, and it seems like more and more the tight end is the guy you have to work.
Santos out now. He'll kick it away. This will be taken to the back of the end zone. It'll bring it a few past the 20 to the 23-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit. The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
Under four to go now as the clock runs and they come up on second down.
Here we go now.
And on the ground they go with a running back. And he's able to plow forward up to about the 29, just shy of the 30. 7 yards on the carry, make it third and four coming up.
But you got to give kudos to your offensive line and the guy carrying the ball because they were in a second and long situation. It seemed pretty dire, but they brought it back to third and manageable with that run.
On third down, that's Lindsey, and he's going to lose yards. They take him down at the 26. And a loss of three to bring up four.
He has elite instincts from his linebacker spot. He's able to diagnose the run and flies in like a missile to stop that one behind the line of scrimmage.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. He's going to have his running back. It's complete. And they're able to get this one across the 35. That's a fourth down pickup of 10 yards and an opportunity certainly missed on the defensive side. They go play action here on first down. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
One thing I have learned, receivers don't mind high throws so much to the sideline, but do that over the middle to them, and not only are the DBs going to throw a little verbal trash their way, when they get back to the huddle, they're going to have a few words to say to their QB, aren't they?
Yeah, hung out to dry a little bit there on the high throw. Luckily, fell incomplete. To throw again, Hogan. And incomplete. He tried to leave it underneath. Nearly got picked. They may be lucky to have that one back. Third down.
Let's phrase this delicately, okay? Might have had a better option instead of throwing the football into double coverage.
He was blanketed. I was surprised that he went his direction.
Yeah, should have thought maybe about the check down. Take the completion. Keep moving.
To throw on third down. Hogan. He's got a man. It's Sutton that's complete. Past the 20. And all the way home for a Broncos score. Cortland Sutton, 63 yards. And the Broncos are an extra point away from tying the football game. And now the offense is going to stay out there as the Broncos will go for two.
Gone, 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 gone.
And movement by one of the Broncos up front, and in comes the flag. On here, Brandon McManus for the point after. Extra point from McManus is good, and we are tied at seven. So we're right back where we started, all even as the kick's away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out will cost him about 5 yards as he'll get this only back to the 20. And Tampa Bay trots out there now. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
Winston and the Bucs take over now, first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. And they'll try the ground game here with the running back. And a decent gain there as that takes us to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes to play in a tightly contested first half. We'll come back to Tampa after this timeout. Operating from the 27 now, here's second and three. Now it's a bootleg with Winston. They'll roll him out right. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A very solid gain of 27. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And they're running right through it. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25. That good for 22 and a first down.
That outside handoff to the left, that play has to warm the heart of an offensive line coach because they controlled the left side where they were supposed to. They didn't allow anything to leak from the backside on the right side of the offensive line either. Well played.
Yeah, and it created a big run. A gain of 3, second down.
They went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Now a second down throw for Winston. And it's incomplete.
Basically, you're not going to outwork two guys very often.
Double coverage. I thought he was going to go somewhere else for the football. I get it. That's a stud wide receiver. You want to try to get him the football.
Yeah, sometimes you rely on him a bit too much. You forget the other options that are out there.
They head to the line facing a 3rd and 7 following the incompletion on 2nd down. Play action now, Winston. It's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
But that was certainly an aggressive call and an aggressive play. Instead of just going for the first down, took the shot in the end zone, went for the touchdown.
Yeah, and on 3rd down, they said, forget about the sticks. We want 6. And Santos able to put this one up and through. It's good. And they take the lead here now at 10-7. So that's a 7-play drive that ultimately stalls out there at the end.
And things were a little leaky in the beginning on that drive, weren't they? But how about the front 7? As they got closer to their goal line, things stiffened a little bit close to field goal.
And he'll make it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. And Denver getting set to take the field. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. And now before this first down play, we're going to get a timeout here. As the clock will stop with 45 seconds to go in the first half. This quarterback now 3 out of 5 since taking over as he's given his guys a first down. From the gun, Hogan. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And now we won't see a play on first down. We're going to get a timeout instead. As the clock will stop with 37 seconds to play in this first half. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On first down, Hogan. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Levante David. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. Just over 30 seconds to go in the half. They've got it 1st and 10. Following the interception, Winston. He'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's 2nd down. Second down, Winston. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. Good starting position for the Broncos here as they come up first and 10.
Gone, gone! Gone, gone!
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And nearly picked off there. Almost intercepted. Instead, second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. The final shot before break. Hogan. And he's going to go down. Couldn't get a throw off with the pressure. Maybe that was for the best, as that brings us to the end of this first half of play. So we've hit halftime here in Tampa with the Bucs out in front. As we send you to our EA studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Out come the Buccaneers. They'll have it first to start the third quarter. They have the lead. Now they'll be looking to extend that lead.
And this is where I enjoy talking about one of my favorite subjects, tendency breakers, or counters, as I also like to call them. You've done things in a certain way in the first half, and they've had the ability to see what you've done. They're going to make their adjustments. So guess what? You adjust yourself and try and stay ahead of the pace, because you are looking for some separation in this ballgame.
The adjustment to the adjustment.
Without a doubt. Show them one thing, hit them with something else.
Well, they may want to go back to that one. First play of the drive, good for 15 and a first down. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. First and 10, Winston. Jackson's got it over the middle. And they're well past midfield, just a yard or two shy of the 40. He goes for 18 there as the drive will continue.
Some think the teams really won't throw a slant route unless you have a receiver that has a lot of stature to him. But sometimes the little guys, they get lost in there. People can't really locate them, and they run that quick cut on the slant, and oftentimes they can turn it into big plays.
Now a play fake here on first down. He's going to flip one out here to his running back. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 18 yards on each of the last two plays, and they're picking up big chunks now.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
Some big plays in the passing game on this drive, and here's one out of the running game. So the passing game loosening things up. Now there's room to roam.
The first carry here for Jaquizz Rodgers. He'll get this down inside the 10 for a pickup of about 3. And now they're in the hurry up.
Well, so many times we look at a short run and we praise the offense for trying to set the tempo and establish things. But the defensive guys, hey, they just won the battle there. It wasn't a big run given up. They don't always have to absorb the body blow. Sometimes they dish them out themselves.
And still about 3 yards shy of a first is the 4-yard. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Jaquizz Rodgers, a 5-yard touchdown run. And the Buccaneers here finding a way to stretch their lead. Santos with the extra point, and his guys will take a 10-point lead. Santos out now. He'll kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And he'll wind up getting an extra couple yards here for his trouble as he'll bring this one out to the 27. So now a look at the Broncos as they head back out there for their first possession of the second half.
Back to that Philly. Here we go. Now let's go.
On first and 10, Hogan. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. It's a gain of 6 on the play, and it's a second down. You know, despite the scoreline, I think they've got to like where they are here. They're on the road and just one big play away from getting right back in this game.
I'm going to follow right along with you because the spot they're in now is a credit to their defense. They've kept them in it by making the plays that they've made, and that just means you're one big score away from being right back there.
Now, the question is, can this offense step up and make that play? Because that's been an issue for them in this game. On third down, it's Lindsey, and he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. 9 yards on the pickup there, and it keeps the drive alive. Right back to him on first down. Oh, nice move. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. That one going for a gain of 11 and a Bronco first down.
Despite the score, despite the deficit, no quitting this guy. He's running angry, running through arm tackles. He wants to change what that scoreboard is saying.
A couple of first downs on the drive already as he'll go from the 47 now on first down.
Green 39! Green 39!
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he'll get this down only to about the 46. It was Jason Pierre-Paul who was able to get him down. To throw on second down, Hogan. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds. A really good pickup of 28 yards. Took till the second half, but finally a red zone opportunity here. They've got a first and 10 at the 17.
Hurry up, here we go.
And they'll go on the ground. And they go the wrong way here. Knocked back to the 20. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down.
I know when I was a kid, I always got real excited when I saw those lateral-type runs. But the best backs that made it happen, they put a foot in the ground and just go. That didn't happen.
Now a loose football. The ball comes out, and the Buccaneers have it.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me.
Okay, I'm back to school. You, this is open campus. This is, I should slap it open-handed. Tough life, I told the motto, she need lower standards. Asked her if she had a twin, I feel like Joey Tanner. Big spender, Kris Jenner, I promote the family. Kardashian, see the Benzo, she like, oh, it's happening. Think she called me, think she, cause she never knew her daddy. And my thong black, Rhythm Nation chanting. Boy, don't make me Jackson. Jackson, bodily, what's underground? Underground, underground, frontin' like a ride with the mob. Why shouldn't I charge me, myself, and I? Myself and I play the odds. A yes man, it's just a bobblehead doll. Holler them all, strutting like Pac out the court. Hop out the Porsche, shake that. Got that on menu, the a la carte. Boy, I had to make my point about this wave. Watch for the sharks bounce. Sharks bounce. I gave it up and talking Cuban links. Tell her ain't no weak link in my Cuban link. Only like my age. We was gangin' since the Platinum FUBU days. I got dreams of being Hover, I should move it, yay. Listen, babe, it's so good you think I'm cool with yay. Okay, my diamonds dancing, I could Lisa Ray. Life is hard, but it's easy.
The NFL on EA Sports is in the Steel City at Heinz Field in Pittsburgh, PA. This was the scene just a few moments ago as the Pittsburgh faithful were fired up by the hometown Steelers taking the field. They're all set as they'll match up with the Denver Broncos. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. This will be fielded on the back line of the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line.
Let's go, let's go.
On first and 10, here's Keenum. Sanders has it over the middle. And he'll get it up to the 33-yard line. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. First down, Keenum. Complete out right to Jake Butt. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line. They'll wind up losing 3 yards here. And it'll bring up a second and 13. Now Keenum. Looking for Sanders, and it's intercepted. Picked off by...